UTVUnderground.com.
I'm Joey D with UTVUnderground.com, and we're back in my favorite off-road playground, the Glamis Sand Dunes. We came out here to perform a breakdown on a brand new machine, but this isn't any ordinary breakdown video, and this isn't any ordinary build. This is my personal 2016 Polaris RZR XP4 Turbo, I call the Fat Rod V2. The story of the Fat Rod started almost 10 years ago with the build of our first UTVUnderground.com flagship vehicle. It was a 2005 Yamaha Rhino, and at the time, it was a total trendsetter. What set that machine off, apart from its custom fabrication, was its fantastic paint scheme. The paint was worthy of any badass hot rod out there, and it was laid down by my late great friend, Rick Wally Wallace, better known as Wally World. Wally crushed it with an old school rat rod style theme. So when I decided that I wanted to build a new machine, I wanted to go back to those roots and build a new Fat Rod. Together with John Melvin, Al's Pinstriping, and Exalter Paint, we were able to come up with the scheme you see here. With the theme and the paint scheme already laid out, it was time to hook up with my boy Tim Berendez at SDR Motorsports and come up with a total build concept. We were starting with this brand new 2016 XP4 Turbo platform, but I knew I wanted to go big. This was gonna be my new family dune cruiser. 5 seats was a must. Stereo, navigation, custom dash, lighting, you name it, everything was done. And of course, to top it off, was that killer SDR cage and door panels. Now that you got the idea of what the Fat Rod's all about, let's dive into some of the details. I started with a brand new 2016 Polaris RZR XP4 Turbo and turned the build over to SDR Motorsports. They installed their awesome low slung 4-seat cage that features a removable windshield, front bumper, and industry best opening doors. They also took on the entire project from wiring to plumbing. While the 144 horsepower ProStar engine is certainly powerful, I knew right away I wanted to throw some serious sand, and that's where the crew at Packard Performance came in. We installed their big 210 horsepower kit that features a massive BorgWarner ball bearing turbo capable of up to 500 horsepower. They finished the kit off with their full stainless steel race exhaust and ECU tube. I called on Sandcraft RCR to help us strengthen our driveline and installed their billet engine mounts, drive shaft, billet carrier bearing, and front differential spread carrier and roll pin. Suspension was left up to Grounded 4 and Walker Evans Racing. I wanted the nimbleness of a stock width suspension, but wanted the strength of an aftermarket race-inspired kit. Paired with custom-tuned Walker Evans Racing Velocity Series shocks and Walker Link sway bar links, this suspension is plush, but able to take all the hits. I finished the exterior mods off with a full Vision X LED lighting package. For the dunes, I got this killer custom setup that feature custom UTVUnderground.com edition DWT Sector 3-piece billet wheels wrapped in massive 32-inch Scat Track paddle tires. On the interior, the Fat Rod V2 resembles that of a luxury pre-runner. The carbon fiber starts at the hood and ends at the console thanks to 4Works. The carbon fiber dash by Glasscraft houses our RacePack IQ3 RZR dash system. We installed an ICOM 50-watt race radio and PCI 4-place intercom. You can't have a dune car without the tunes, so I turned to Rockford Fosgate and installed their sick head unit, which helps power our SSV Works 5-speaker system. This thing thumps, and it's always good to roll up to the hill and know that the party can start with the Fat Rod. The final mod to the Fat Rod, but probably not the last, was our Safecraft Auto-Thermal Fire Suppression System. We've always ran fire extinguishers on all of our machines, but now we're taking race car parts and installing them in our play cars. That is mounted directly above our RZR engine. If it reaches a certain temperature, it will automatically detonate. I can't thank Tim at SDR enough for helping bring the Fat Rod V2 to life. And of course, huge thanks to everyone who built, designed, and supplied all of the Rad products to help make this build a true one of a kind.